you're anything like me, you have liked FNAF ever since you were in 6th grade. Now, yes, I know, it is weirdly specific, but stay with me now. So, as you might have just heard, I've liked FNAF since 2014. So when I found out that there was a 3DS port of it, I was like, goo goo gaga. Now, I say that because I did not know how to mod a 3DS then. So basically, I was out of luck there. I had to wait a while in order for that to happen. So anyway, flash forward, 2023. I'm sitting there, right over there, you can't see it, but it's there, thinking, that 3DS is kind of collecting dust. I'm gonna mod it. So then I did mod it. And you know what the first thing I did with it was, when I modded it? Downloading FNAF 3DS. So anyway, that's what the video is about. Enjoy. First though, before we get into that, I must tell you what FNAF is for the two people who do not know. So, Five Nights at Freddy's is a game series where the animatronics do get a bit quirky at night. True story. So anyway, you survive five nights, five in air quotes, because it's always longer than five nights. So you survive for a while, and then you win, or you die. Either way, it has gameplay. Five Nights at Freddy's is on basically everything except the 3DS. Like, that's a travesty. So in come homebrewers to fill the void. Five Nights at Freddy's on 3DS. Nintendo, please don't kill me. FNAF 1 on 3DS is actually really good. Let me explain. So, there are a few things missing, but that's not a huge problem. So for one, it doesn't have Golden Freddy, but that's not too big a problem, I don't think. Either way though, it's enough of a difference to justify being said, I feel. So FNAF 1 on 3DS plays pretty much the exact same as FNAF 1, except it gets really difficult at night 4 or 5. It gets really difficult, like insanely difficult. Yeah. So anyway, I didn't finish any of these, either that be because I couldn't physically do it, like, it wasn't possible, I couldn't do it because I'm bad at the game, or I couldn't do it because the game decided to murder me, basically. Anyway, Night 1 of FNAF 1 is, you know, the same as FNAF 1, like on any other platform. You close the doors. You turn on the lights, you see an animatronic, you close the door, look at Foxy. That's basically the game. Now this game, as you might have noticed, doesn't look as good as it did in 2014.
You know, I'd like to see you running on a 3DS, see how good you look.
Anyway, but there's a weird graphical thing where when you turn on the lights, the office becomes blurry, which I don't know why that happens. Honestly, I'm not a game developer. I just play the games. But yeah, the office gets really blurry. That's not really a big issue, though, because FNAF 1 can still be played, like, without, like, total clearance at all times. That wasn't the right word. Whatever. Night 2 seems pretty normal. Night 3 also seems normal. However, Night 4... Night 4 sure was something. So anyway, weird thing. I don't know if this is a thing in FNAF 1. I'm not gonna check. But the power in Night 4 drained insanely fast. Like, I'll put it up there right now. It drained extremely fast. And that eventually led to my death. Another point that I want to touch upon before moving on to the next game is that Foxy's, like, running down the hallway animation didn't play. Like, ever. Now, this doesn't mean that he didn't work, because boy did Foxy work. I think he was the most active animatronic, probably. Even when I was checking. But anyway, his run animation didn't play, it was just the noise. Now granted, you don't have any evidence of audio in any way, because I was not able to record it from my 3DS streaming directly to my PC. However, trust me, it was there. FNAF 2 on 3DS was the most unfinished game in this video. I'm gonna preface with that. None of the animatronics were active. The music box button was not there. Once I got to 6 a.m., it just kept running. And then after 6 a.m. was up, the time just disappeared entirely. There was no death screen, no death animations, no jump scares. The lights worked. I know that. But yeah. Speaking of lights, actually, when I tried to see if depleting the flashlight would end the run, sure did end the run of my 3DS. It crashed my game. My game crashed. Yeah. Yeah. It was not a very, it was very unfinished. Most unfinished one here. I can say that with full confidence, because I actually played the last three of these games on the day of recording. So yeah. FNAF 3 was interesting. Of course, Night 1 was uneventful, because that's how it is in FNAF 3. There was nothing happening. The status effects didn't do anything at all. There were no, like, phantom animatronics at all in that one. None, period. And Springtrap did not want to go to my office to end my run, because it was getting excruciatingly long at the end of it. I'll put that here. It was going so long, I don't know why. But yeah, FNAF 3 was definitely more finished, at least, compared to FNAF 2. In Night 2, Springtrap functioned. Like, he actually functioned. You could lure him. Yeah. He didn't want to kill me, though. That was very weird. Oh, right. Status effects didn't do anything at all, so I found a way to cheese this one. So anyway, for most of the nights that I was playing, which was 9, by the way, don't know why so many, for most of those, I was just spamming audio in Cam 10. And Springtrap he wasn't able to kill me. I don't know if he would have been able to kill me anyway, after seeing Night 8, but, yeah. So anyway, there was the actual mechanic of the night system in the game, so that was an improvement over the last one. But for some reason, it just seemed to go on forever, and I eventually just decided to not continue playing, because I'm sure it would have gone on for the rest of my life. Status effects didn't do anything except create, like, a visual difference. That's all they did. Oh, and with the ventilation one, when you reset it, if you didn't get it when the blinking of the lights was, like, at the green, it basically froze the entire animation in place when you repaired the system. It definitely caused for some visibility issues. Luckily though, Springtrap never went to my window. Also, I didn't even need to repair the systems in hindsight because it didn't do anything, and I could have just spam audio at Cam 10 anyway, so didn't really do me any good to go to the repair dock, whatever you call it. But yeah, I was able to cheese that by just spamming Cam 10 with audio lures until the night ended. It was my second most boring run, but no, I don't have anything. It just got boring being able to cheese it so easily, not being able to die. Yeah. Okay, so FNAF 4 is one of my least favorite games in the franchise because I suck at it. So anyway, this one appears to be fully functional though. Like, you can move to the doors, to the closet, you can look behind the bed, you can flash light. The breathing system is in there. It appears that all of the animations are intact too, like, weirdly impressive given that that hasn't really been a constant for any of the other FNAF 3DS unofficial ports. But yeah, it appeared to be fully functional, except for Fun with the Flesh Trap and the mini-games in between nights. Those were not in there. However, that's not too much of a concern for me, because, like, it was still fun, kind of. Like, not as fun, because I don't like the game as much, but, like, it worked. It played exactly like I remembered it. Except, well, no, it worked very well. And yeah, all of the animations were intact, which was really impressive to me. And it just worked. Yeah. And then I died on night 2 and gave up. Anyway, if I had to rank them, which I'm doing right now, I'd put FNAF 1 on the very top. That one was my favorite out of these. Then I'd put FNAF 4, FNAF 3 in third place. And FNAF 2 at the bottom, because it just didn't work. It did not work. Anyway, thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed my first video of the year. I sure enjoyed making it. And I will see you guys later. Bye.